Yo, what's up, everyone? It's your boy, Vanilla Ice, and I'm bringing you a new song. It's a new song, but an old song. It's a good song called Ice, Ice, Baby. Yo, DJ, hit it. Hey, Squints. Every molecule has a shape, or a specific way the atoms are placed. Each molecule looks different depending on what atoms it has. The air we breathe, for example, which is carbon dioxide, has atoms in the shape of a straight line, like this. Other molecules have hexagons in it and can be very complicated, but water molecules are shaped like triangles. This shape is important because when you freeze water, the triangle molecules line up to form a hexagon with six sides. Once every water molecule is frozen, you get a bunch of hexagons packed together, which is what gives ice its unique properties. For example, snowflakes are made from frozen water vapor, which is water molecules that are floating around in the air. The molecules freeze into hexagons, which is why snowflakes have six arms, one arm for each corner of the hexagon. In addition to forming snowflakes, water has some other interesting things that can happen when it freezes. If you take bottled water, which should be pretty close to pure H2O molecules in here, and freeze it just right, you can get what's called supercooled water. That's super cool water. Also supercooled water, which is actually a word. Water normally freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. Most freezers are about 20 degrees colder than that. So it's possible to get water to the temperature it should freeze at without it actually becoming solid ice. That's because for water to freeze into ice, it needs something to grab in order to form those hexagon crystals. For a snowflake, it's dust or other little specks in the air. For non-filtered water, for tap water, it's impurities. But for pure water, each water molecule is surrounded by more water molecules, making it harder to make that initial hexagon form. We can jumpstart this freezing process by giving it a good thumping, like this. Like a domino effect, water starts lining up in those crystal hexagons. Another weird thing ice does is that it floats. Most solids will sink in a liquid because a solid has its molecules packed close together. But ice floats. With these hexagon ice crystals, there are holes in between each molecule, meaning the molecules aren't packed as tightly as it could be compared to liquid water. And if they aren't packed as tight, then ice is less dense, causing it to float. You can see this in action by comparing how much space ice takes up when it's frozen compared to when it's melted. Those hexagon holes in frozen water spread out the water molecules, making it take up more room. Kind of like when your grandma decides to play Tetris and she's not very good. So keep drinking water, keep asking questions, and keep on squinting. Have a question you want answered? Okay, well then leave it in the comments below and don't forget to subscribe for more Invisible Science. Where did I go? I'm invisible.